Good morning to everybody. I hope you all safe at your home, stay safe. Have you ever seen horror movie or horror show? What do you feel when you watch a horror movie? Is there an atmosphere of fear or horror? Yes, it is. The poem which we are going to see today, the poem which full of mystery, horror and suspense. The poem name is The Listeners, written by Walter de la Mare. He was an English poet, short story writer and novelist. He was born on 1873 and he died on 1956. He is best known for his works for children. The Listeners is said to be his most famous poem. The poet in the poem has created a beautiful scene full of mystery and fear. The Listeners is a long poem. In the poem, an unnamed figure, the traveler, knocks on the door of a house in the moonlight and asks if there is anybody inside. He visited a house in the jungle. The house was lonely and deserted. It was a haunted house. Ghosts lived in it. The traveler got down from his horse and knocked at its door again and again. He repeatedly shouted for some time and got no answer. The poet creates an atmosphere of silence, fear and suspense. Shall we get into the poem? First, I read the poem. Listen carefully. Is there anybody there? Said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door. And as horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest ferny floor, and a bird flew up out of the turret above the traveler's head. And he smote upon the door again a second time. Is there anybody there? He said, but no one dissented to the traveler. No head from the leaf fringed sill leaned over and looked into his grey eyes, where he stood perplexed and still. But only a host of phantom listeners that dwelt in the lone house then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men, stood thronging the faint moonbeams on the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall, hearkening in an air stirred and shaken by the lonely traveler's call. Okay. Let's see the explanation of the poem. Is there anybody there? Said the traveler, knocking on the moonlit door. And his horse in the silence champed the grasses of the forest ferny floor. And a bird flew up out of the turret above the traveler's head. Let's see the explanation of these lines. The poem opens with a question, is anybody there? The opening line introduces the poem's main character, sets the scene and poses the question that is central to the mystery of the story. The subject of the poem is a traveler. He has come on a horseback from some unknown location into the scene of the poem and suddenly makes his presence by knocking on the door of the house and asking if anyone is there. It was a moonlit night. A traveler came to the door of a house in the forest. He had come to keep an unnamed promise and knocked at the door, calling the householders to open the door. Silence was the answer to his call. His horse was chewing grass of the forest ferny floor, and the bird flew over the roof of the house. The bird also flew over the traveler's head. Here, champed means bit and chipped upon noisily. Ferny means consisting of flowerless plants. Turret means a small tower that projects from the wall of a building. And he smote upon the door again a second time. "Is there anybody there?" he said. But no one descended to the traveler. No head from the leaf-fringed sill leaned over and looked into his grey eyes, where he stood perplexed and still. Here, smote means knocked loudly. Sill means a horizontal piece of timber beneath a window or a door. Perplexed means confused. Okay, let's see the explanation. He knocked at the door second time and he inquired if there was anybody in the house. The traveler's second knock went unheeded too, for no one descended the stairs and looked out of the leaf-fringed window still to inquire who had come. He became impatient and fearful. Loneliness surrounded him and he equally became confused. But only a host of Pantham listeners that dwelt in the lone house then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men, stood thronging the faint moonbeams on the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall, hearkening in an air stirred and shaken by the lonely traveler's call. Here, thronging means crowding. Hearkening means listening attentively. Let's see the explanation. When the traveler was standing confused and still, the host of ghosts that lived in the lonely house stood listening in the silence of the moonlight to the voice of the human. In the dull moonlight, they stood crowded on the dark steps which lead to the empty hall in the house. They were attentively listening to the call of the lonely travelers, which disturbed the calm environment. I hope you all understood this poem. Okay. Students, this is for your homework. Find a line from the poem to match the pictures given below and write it in the blank. And read the statements and say true or false. This is for your homework. Do the homework properly and submit your homework on time. Okay. Thank you, students.